Please be seated. Time travelers abound in fiction. I've read at least 20 novels or short stories about them, and I've seen countless movies and TV shows. You may have as well. Usually someone goes back in time, perhaps because the future, being unknown, is too scary. The interesting choice is when, to what time do they want to go back? In all of those plots with which I'm familiar, strangely, no one wants to go back to antiquity and walk around with Jesus or even gaze on him in the manger. Maybe I just haven't come across those novels yet. But I want to do that. After I brushed up on my Aramaic, I know exactly the time and place to which I would travel. Picture a desert scene. Everybody was wondering and talking about what was going on. They traveled a long ways out into the wilderness to find out. By some accounts, a homeless man had called the religious leaders a brood of vipers. He said some scary things about an axe and an unquenchable fire. He was washing away their sins in the river. After one man was baptized, everyone heard a great voice from heaven say, "You are my son, the beloved. With you I am well pleased." Why is this moment in time important to me? I believe it is a pivot point in the history of our species. A human being was identified as the Son and Beloved, in whom the one in heaven is well pleased. I want to see that one. I want to see what Beloved of the Creator looks like. Did he smile? Did he look terrified? Did he look like a child who had received the approval of his father? We know what happened next. He went to a more remote place for 40 days and was tempted by Satan. I don't need to see that. Just his face. What does Beloved look like? Well, I have found that Beloved can look like any one of us. How is that? Jesus, representing all of Israel, received John's baptism for the forgiveness of sins. St. Paul is clear that we are baptized into Christ. We are baptized into the Beloved One of God Almighty. Is it true, even if we don't feel it? Maybe we don't believe it. Maybe we are stuck in despair. Well, I get stuck in verse 6 of Psalm 22, which we always recite on Good Friday. I am a worm and no man. It's probably not a healthy meditation. I am a worm and no man. When that wormy feeling comes, we can say to ourselves, but I am baptized into the Beloved. Or maybe we're living in verse 11. Be not far from me, for trouble is near, and there is none to help. Add this phrase, but I am baptized into the Beloved. Or verse 14, I am poured out like water. All my bones are out of joint. My heart within my breast is melting wax. But I am baptized into the Beloved. His baptism put him on a trajectory to his crucifixion. When he began reciting this psalm from the cross, and others around him acted it out like a screenplay. That too is what Beloved looks like. I don't need to look on his crucifixion because I would see that face, the Beloved One with a broken and slowly dying body. Someday, maybe I'll need to look when my body is broken and dying. And I'll know that I am baptized into the Beloved, the resurrected one. and maybe, just maybe, people who don't understand anything about Jesus Christ will look upon us and they too will see the Beloved. Do we look like we are beloved of the Father? Because if we are, then we can show that face to a world suffering from despair. And in that moment, the hope of Christmas will be fulfilled. Amen.
Amen.